say hi, Kane? Last time they seen you, you had ears. Beardy. You know what? Kane and Beardy. Beauty, of course, is the bad one. They gotta get up. Sit your ass down. Hey! What did that thing do? Sit down. She gotta be the bad one. But of course, you see, she's the only one that's playing down. Then you got the other one. Kane. Son. Who's bad. Hard-headed. Got spikes on his neck. He's a little bit more... He's the bitchy one. They really just both work my nerves. Ain't that right, little one? Say hi. Hello, my ears are fine. I made it through it. Okay, hey. Do it all. You need to do the bare minimum. This is the beast. Beauty is the beast. I had somebody coming off of me $2,000 for my girl the other day. So, no, we can't have all that, right, baby? Say hi, you didn't get to meet everybody last time, so you didn't. Say hi, say I'm Beauty. Alright. Chill out. So, we're gonna do some questions and answers. Now, before I get started, I just want to say that, you know, I love play with everybody. I don't mind the you know, sometimes you just want to ask some shit, but I had two individuals on my page that just did the absolute fucking most when they should have done the bare minimum. I mean, out of 90-something comments, it was like in between two people. One of them got deleted. And the other one I left on to make an example of the first one. I like to get down and dirty. Don't get it wrong. But at the same time, there's a little word called respect. Now, if I was with somebody, that would have been very disrespectful. And I feel like there's a way to ask those kind of questions. It's not that they were just terribly bad, you know what I'm saying? But it was just the words that were used were very vulgar, very disrespectful, very just made me want to throw up. So yeah, let's try to respect a little bit more the next time, okay? But I'm gonna answer a couple of questions out of the 90 something questions that were there from the other people that did get on there. And then I'm going to go ahead and hit the second status that I had put up with, I think it's like 40-something questions on there. So I'm going to do as many as I can. Because I do have to get ready. Because tomorrow we're going where? DMV! What is wrong with you? What is wrong with your life? You think you're fine and you can just get away with everything, don't you? Sound like Beauty! But, tomorrow is DMV. I will be in the DMV area, landing approximately around 2-ish. So, I'm looking forward to that. I hear that a friend of mine is going to be there, so I'm very excited about that. So, hello. That's motherfucking right. King Kells is going to be in the building with me tomorrow night at the Hangers Club. So we're definitely about to get it popping. Got some birthdays going on. You know what I'm saying? I hear it's the spot to be. So I'm very, very excited to come. I'm so excited to come that I got a new outfit made just for y'all. So I can't wait to come. Shouts out to Jerry. Shouts out to Mo. It's definitely going down tomorrow, so can't wait to go. Also, Poetic Therapy. I am a very, very big fan of the spoken word. So, therefore, I will be attending the spoken word here in San Antonio on the 16th of February at Uptown 78. Great poets. I got some footage from the last session that I went to. I think I had a booking the next day, so I just really had a lot to do. And I haven't gotten around to putting it up, but I am a big fan of the spoken word. And just to show them how much of a fan I am, I'm bringing one of my dearest friends to come and play live for them that night. So shout out to Dev Soul. If you don't know who Dev Soul is, Google her. One of the hottest bands out here. I mean, that girl can sing her ass off, and they can play damn near every song. I mean, from your Lauryn Hills to your Mary J's to your Jill Scott's to your Floetry, you name it, they rock that motherfucking stage, and it's a live band. So that's just my way of contributing to them. I love Madrea, Mother Earth. Let me tell y'all about Mother Earth. No, you know what? Let me not tell y'all about but Mother Earth, mommy, I cannot wait to see you killing it, and I am very excited. I'm going to put on my Sunday's best for you. So, yeah, the double-breasted soups. I mean, that's out. Ow! They did it again! Look! I was in Houston this weekend and I was cooking and I burned my wrist and they just busted it open! Stop it! Still! Stop! You just hurt mommy. Yeah, you! You! Betty!
She's like, you're not talking to me.
Sit your butt down! Sit it down! Sit it! Fucking. You better not get your ass up no more, little boy. Hey, sit it down. OMG, they just busted my burner. You think I'm playing with you? I'm gonna jack you up in front of all these people. And they're gonna see you get your ass whooped. They're gonna make fun of you at Splash when you're on the beach. Did you catch that? They gonna make fun of you at Splash while we on the beach. Let me just touch on these contests real quick before we jump into this Q&A, because I really don't want this to drag on and we have to do like 30 parts. So yeah, we're going to try to speed this up a little bit, but I have not one but two contests going on. I know it's a lot of people that hear about Splash that want to come down for Splash, you know. I personally don't just have $200-$300 sitting around to get a plane ticket, another $200-$300 for a room and food, and you know, another couple $100 to get in clubs and shit like that. So if I'm that kind of person, and I know there's a lot of people in the world, and I'm just being real, it is nothing to be embarrassed about, but not everybody just has money sitting around, but they want to come down, they want to be a part of the festivities, they want to come enjoy, you know, Houston Splash, because it is Houston's Splash. So, you know, Flawless Eyes is going to be having a lot of great events going on. I will be there with her throughout the whole damn thing, and I cannot wait. And, you know, we decided to do a contest. I'm a writer. I love to write. I love to read. So, yeah, I don't mind anybody coming down, but you already going to be here damn near for free. $20 and some writing ain't nothing. So if you really want to come, it'll give you, you know, backstage access, me, all the dancers that'll be there, meet and greets with any celebs that'll be there, free access to all the clubs and all the events. We're taking care of your food, we're taking care of your room and board, we're taking care of your flight, we're taking care of everything. So it's $20 to enter that contest. And then you have to submit an essay that's no less than 100 words. And basically, I want you to pick one thing that you would change about your LGBT community. And once you pick that, I want you to write about it and why. Everybody has a lot of opinions on about the LB. You know, this, you know, talk about it. Write it up. Send it to me. $20. PayPal. You know what I'm saying? To get you in the contest. We're going to be announcing the winner March the 6th. So, everything set up is there for you. You know, there's a lot of things that's just easy for people. I don't like to make it easy for nobody. I want you to be able to use your mind and send it to me. And the reason why I picked that topic is because I'm here trying to do as much as I can do for the LGBT community. So if there's something that I can't change, I can definitely try and tackle it and make it my mission to try to do that. So it's not just about, you know, you guys setting an image. Tell me what you want me to work on. Me and Flawless are already tag teaming the Beats 8 Foundation here in San Antonio with a woman named Karen. So I'm loving that. I'm very supportive of the spoken word. So I'm contributing to that. And I contribute to a lot of different things, and I'm continuing to contribute. And the more that I do, the more that I make, the more that I can do that. So definitely, I want you guys to submit it. Take some time out of your day. Do something positive. Because there's a lot of youngsters that are watching us, older ones. You know, there's so many kids that just want to be dancers now because, I mean, it's like you don't have to be a dancer in order to give back to your community. I don't promote for them to grow up and want to be an entertainer. I'm always pushing them towards school, towards anything that they may be passionate about. You know what I mean? Because it's almost, you can do almost anything. Stop that. Stop it. Stop biting your nails. It's annoying. You're going to town on them. She's over here like, stop it. Because then you're going to leave them on top of my computer. That's not cute. Stop it. Stop. That's a wrap. It's a wrap.
I can't remember pick your step.
Yeah, well, that's fine. Because you don't do that either. Don't pick your feet. Sorry. Oh, yeah. You got today. You got to go back and forth? Do you? Because we can do it. We can get it. I don't give a fuck. This is real motherfucking life right here. Do you want to go at it? Ain't no scripts over here. Ain't nothing going on over here that they can't know about. I don't keep shit from them motherfuckers. Y'all know that. You ready? You done? Okay, so back to what I was saying. We could definitely get some shit going to, you know, show them that, you know, it's so many people that just send me their writings. They send me poetry. They send me a bunch of shit. So use it. $100 will get you with me. All of Splash, my team. We're definitely going to be at every event. We're going to kill it on the beach. I mean, we're bringing motorcycles. 9 times out of 10, the Rough Riders will be with us. You know, of course, Kane and Beauty going to be with us. $100 or more. But $20 to get you in the contest. Also, the second contest I got is Valentine's Day. Even though I do not have a Valentine, I wish I had a Valentine.
I wish I had a Valentine.
I don't want you to be my Valentine. What? My Valentine. I hate you. This is what you know. Okay, I'm over it. I'm over it.
There you go. Bitch, you fine. No phones.
It's the way here. Anyways. So I don't have a Valentine's, but I know that just because I hate Valentine's Day this year doesn't mean that everybody else does. So I'm gonna put together a basket for you guys. And I mean, like, this basket's gonna be like huge. I used to work at Michael's, so you know what I'm saying? I know how to put some shit. I can make a whole fucking centerpiece for fucking Thanksgiving. I get it in. Okay, I get it in. I can make your floor arrangement, a spray, whatever fuck you need. You know what I'm saying? I can do it. But I'm definitely going to get, you know, it's going to be a lot of stuff in there. Some perfume, some lotions, of course, a teddy bear. Yeah, okay. I don't tell them. An exclusive. I give you guys an exclusive.
They get a picture of me.
You get a picture of me.
Yeah.
But yeah, let's start with these questions. But anyways, the contest is it started already. Are the questions up?
No, we need 4 more questions. They'll be up today.
Okay, so the questions will be up today. Basically, what it is 14 questions about me in 14 minutes. The first one that gets them all right, I will personally send you your Valentine's Day package. I'm going to overnight it to you. So it'll be there on Valentine's Day, jam-packed with goodies. And when I say goodies, like, I'm putting some in it. I put all the in it. I might be in my damn set. I might just pack my motherfucking self up in there so somebody can love on me for a fucking Valentine's Day. Bitch! I'm not gonna do this on camera today. Okay. Wait. Okay. I'm good. I'm back. Cause tomorrow I'll be at DMB. King motherfucking Cam. Now here are other people are gonna be there too, so I can't wait. And then we got Tennessee. What's the name of that fucking group? With the old man. A game of horseshoes. Oh my God, but yes, Tennessee. Pretty P is coming your mother way. Coming. What day is that?
February the
11th. I hear Virginia called. I hear North Carolina called. I hear a lot of people called. So I can't wait. Little Rock?
Yeah.
Oh, really? I'm having fun. And I am excited. I cannot wait. So Tennessee is going down. I also want to give a special shout out to She Zone Magazine. They put me as Entertainer of the Month. And I'm still there. And I'm loving it. I support them. I support what they're doing. If you don't know about it, www.shezone.org. So definitely go check it out. It's good. They showed me a lot of love. And I was very flattered and honored that somebody asked me to do that. So shout out to Shezone, man. Y'all is the shit. Like I said, if y'all don't know about them, check them out. www.shezone.org. So let's make it happen, okay? Show support to what we're doing, because we're making a dent in the world. And we multiply by the day. There's going to be different things opening up. And in order for us to continue to stay afloat, we need all the support that we can do. So if there's people out here trying to do positive things and give more lesbians, more things, engage them, LGBT community, period. Support it. Support. It's going to open more doors for everybody. So that way, the only thing we have is not just clubs. We're worth more. We deserve more. And we going to get more. Fuck with me, we going to have more. Watch me work. Bitch! Game horseshoes! Arrested Development. Ain't it? Look it up. Arrested Development. We gotta look this up. I gotta know if I'm like, isn't this a Game of Horseshoes? You know the old man in Tennessee. No? My lady. My baby. Hey. We talking about eternity. Oh yeah, I was supposed to not be drinking these, so I guess I'm busted. Oh, but yeah. Oh well. I like my size. Am I supposed to be like upset? I like my size. Don't try to call me names. Don't laugh at me. Don't get your pleasure from my play. Yo, who knows country? Y'all know that. In God's eyes, we're all the same. Don't laugh at me. No, I like my size, so I mean, if you try to make me feel uncomfortable about it, it's not gonna work. Because if anything, I want to be a little bit thicker, a little bit bigger. Just to show these skinny motherfuckers out here that us big bitches can rock with it too. Wait, what's that? Oh, shit. Misha, I got the DJ in the house now. DJ in the house. Oh, my snuggums, you guys are sleepy, being good babies. Mama's little boy and girl. They don't even wake up. Okay, so. Yeah, get your contests on. You know what I'm saying? Get your TPP on. You know what I'm saying? Come rock with me. And let's do it. Let's do it big. You know, we do shit big in Texas. That's what Pretty Pete does. I can't do nothing half-ass. It's got to be big. And if you ain't ready for my birthday that's coming up in April, then I suggest that you get ready, because we got some of the hottest entertainers in the world coming down. They got a lot of surprises that I don't even know about. But it's going down. Flawless. I'll be with Flawless on the 18th in Houston, Texas at Club Epic for her anniversary. DC Dallas is going to be there, and King Kel is going to be there, as well as myself. So it's going down, and more performers are going to be there as well. So Big Event, it's her anniversary. 30th year anniversary? 3-year anniversary. Or 3-year anniversary, I'm not mistaken, but it's one of the two. But yeah, it's definitely going down. Everybody knows. It just because it don't say Oz in the back of my name does not mean I'm a motherfucking Oz. I rock with the motherfucking Diva Oz fucking movement. That was a lot of fuckings in that sentence, but it is what it is. So, I'm a motherfucking Oz. You don't like it, kiss my motherfucking ass. Straight the fuck up. Can I have my thicker than a snicker? I just like that, because we're thicker than a motherfucking snicker. And I don't give a fuck. Okay, I'm done. We gotta get back to work. We gotta focus, because these people are waiting for me to say something that I'm supposed to say and starting these questions, and I'm just blabbering on. Sorry, I said I wasn't gonna do that. But yeah, one more thing. New Orleans Club Twist 504. My girl Daphne is going down. We're definitely gonna be in New Orleans for the 21st of February. Now, I told myself I was not gonna take a booking on that day, because that would mark my mom's 6-year anniversary of her passing. So it's gonna be a difficult day for me. It's gonna be a challenging day for me, but I'm definitely gonna get it in, because my mother would want me to work. She wouldn't want me just to stop what I'm doing and just be a mess. The first 2 years after she passed away, I was just like a huge fucking mess. So I know that she would want me to do what I gotta do. And so I'm gonna do so. But yeah, it's gonna be a hard day for me. So I will be in New Orleans, Mardi Gras, the 21st, Club Twist 504. And we got plenty more coming. Oh, King Kel's gonna be there too. They just be, you know, they know that me and Kel's are faggots. Big dick faggots. King Ding-a-ling all day. I'm gonna give me a shirt that says King Ding-a-ling. I belong to King Ding-a-ling. Bitch! I hate girls. No, I don't. I love women. But yeah, I belong to King Family. I love that bitch. Hello? Hello? Dallas? Motherfucking Texas. Dallas, Texas is on the 17th. I will be at Club... I'll be at the Woodman, and then I'll be celebrating Tracy's birthday with
Bolaes.
Rudy Scott's gonna be there. Bolaes gonna be there. Myself. It's just gonna be a huge celebration. So I cannot wait to see my people in D Town. I am coming back to the D. You know what I'm saying? I might have to give somebody the D while I'm at. I don't fucking know. I'm gonna see what kind of tricks I feel like pulling out of my bag. But guess what? I'm getting some new outfits made for y'all too. So, going down. Wait, how does another trick say it? It's going down, down, down. No. Big boy. Love P. Watching ride by on the blue. Hold on, can I get it?